Hello, my name is José de Ramón Rivera. And this work is a collaboration with Eduardo Martín Martínez and Luis Garay. And it's called, we're going to talk about the thermalization time scale, KMS detail balance, and its relation with the Anti Unruh phenomena. So let me start with the setup. The context of this work is the well-known Unruh debut model, which describes a detector following a certain trajectory, space-temporal, and coupled with a real scalar field. The scalar is described by this interaction Hamiltonian, which is characterized by a coupling constant. This guy is a switching function. We will assume that is strongly supported and smooth in this argument. And it's characterized as well by the sigma, which is not but a time scale, which regulates the duration of the interaction. This mu is the monopole moment of the detector, and this phi is the real scalar field evaluated along the trajectory x sub tau. With this model, we can calculate excitation probability. This is the detector is initially at the ground state, and we calculate the probability that the detector goes to the excited state. This probability takes this form, and we see that this is not but the Fourier transform of the switching function times this W, which is not but the Weimann function, evaluated at two different points of the trajectory at this state row. This omega is the energy gap of the two-level system which describes the detector. So, with this model, we reproduce the Unruh effect. But we got that detectors with an accelerated trajectory, uniformly accelerated trajectory, and at the vacuum for sufficiently long times, this is sigma tending to infinity, generates a thermal response of the detector, characterized by this Planckian distribution with this temperature which is proportional to the acceleration. We see that with these considerations, we have that the excitation to the excitation ratio, this is the quotient of the probability of the excitation and the decay probability, tends, as sigma tends to infinity, to a function which is an exponential that does not depend on the interaction time, and this the exponent is this omega over the acceleration. However, recently, Brenna, Rothman, Martin Martinez have studied this model in the context of the 1+1 dimensions for finite cavities and with the introduction of infrared cutoffs, studying the continuum. They studied this model in the context of, as well, short interaction times. What they saw is the detector seems to have a cool down as the acceleration increases. This is the expected behavior of a detector accelerated. We see that as the acceleration increases, the excitation probability increases as well. And in these regimes that they explore, what they saw is that this excitation decreased with the acceleration. And as well, what they saw is that in these regimes, there are an apparent detail balance. This is, this excitation to the excitation ratio seems to hold with this exponential form we have mentioned it earlier. And it seems that the detector has some kind of apparent equilibrium in these conditions. Then this Anti Unruh phenomena raises us the following questions. For example, is this Anti Unruh phenomena a transient phenomena due to the short interaction times? And then, what does this excitation to the excitation ratio? What information give us this excitation to the excitation ratio? And in what conditions this excitation to the excitation ratio give us the information about the temperature of the detector? And as well, if there are time scale in which the detector has thermalized, with what is, and how this thermalization, take it into account at the time scale, is taking place. And of course, what is the cause of this anti Unruh phenomena? Is an effect due to the acceleration, or is an effect a dimensional effect, or is due maybe to the introduction of the finite size cavities or infrared cutoffs? So, for answering that questions, these questions, let me take the analysis to a different frame, and let's study detectors in thermal baths at arbitrary interaction times. These detectors in thermal baths are determined by this static trajectory and with a thermal Wideman function. This thermal Wideman function will be characterized by the so-called KMS condition. This is, if we have the Wideman function defined, it must have this anti-periodicity condition. This is assume this imaginary quantity to the first argument, change the argument in the evolution times. Or in terms of the Fourier transform of the Wideman functions, we have this quotient tends to the exponential form. What about thermalization of the detectors? What we can check is that the excitation probability can be written in terms of the Fourier transforms of the switching function times the Fourier transform of the Wideman function. We see that when this sigma bar, which is not that the interaction time in terms of the Heisenberg time of the detector, is greater than 1, we can drop this dependence and put out this Wideman function from the integral. And then we have that the thermalization is checked in the sense that the detector balance is fulfilled. Then we have that this excitation to excitation ratio satisfies the detector balance condition for interaction times well above the Heisenberg time. Nonetheless, we see that this excitation to excitation ratio does not give any information of the state near or below of this. We have that for this interaction times more or less at the time of the Heisenberg time of the detector, this excitation to excitation ratio seems to have this exponential form with this effective beta that depends on the interaction time in this form. This is a result that comes from an exact calculation of this series. So, what about anti-Unruh phenomena in thermal baths? For check any kind of anti-Unruh phenomena, what we have is that the excitation probability, the derivative with respect to the temperature, must be negative. Or what is the same, the derivative with respect to the inverse temperature beta must be greater than 0. A necessary condition for that is that Wideman function transform be as well greater than 0 in some place of the domain of definition. What we get is that we do not find this anti-Unruh phenomena nor for 3 plus 1 dimensions, nor for 1 plus 1 dimensions, nor for massive fields, and with any kind of introduction of cutoffs, without the introduction of cutoffs. Then, anti-Unruh phenomena are characteristic of accelerated detectors, and they can distinguish the problem of the Unruh model formulated in an accelerated frame from a thermal bath. What about the anti-Unruh phenomena? Where is the cause of the anti-Unruh phenomena? In 1 plus 1 dimension, we saw that the anti-Unruh phenomena are discovered by these researchers. And for 3 plus 1 dimensions, we have that with in the free space, the Wideman function deals with KMS condition and then stationarity, and the case is the same with a thermal bath. This is the condition. But with the introduction of infrared cutoff, we have that this condition, the KMS condition for the Wideman function in the proper time of the detector is broken. And we have not a stationarity anymore. Conclusions. The thermalization time scale is the Heisenberg time scale of the detector. for times below the Heisenberg time, the excitation to excitation ratio does not give any information about the state of the detector. The form of the switching function affects the thermalization via its derivatives, as we can see there. And we get, by the other hand, that the anti-Unruh phenomena are not found for a KMS state of scalar fields, this for thermal states of scalar fields in any relevant case. And they must be due to the introduction of cutoffs in the case of accelerated detectors in inertial reference frames. So thank you very much. Thank you.